how does this affect IT? They've got to be busier. This has to be more difficult on them, having half the people in the office and now half the people in remote office.
Yeah, that's a great question. So I'm just going to say that, you know, the technology hasn't really changed. It's how we use it and how we're consuming it. That's changed. And what was previously, before COVID and the outbreak, what was previously used to increase efficiencies and for convenience, now they're a gotta have for conducting business in this new hybrid model. Things like meeting places and team spaces, video conferencing, video collaboration, instant messaging and presence. And how many of us have checked our presence jelly bean on this thing before we take our dog out for a walk because the boss might be watching, right? So, I mean, that's right, kind of the going forward new normal. With this, all these changes, these new network architecture changes, there's new challenges for IT. A couple of examples I would call out are like the Internet of Things. So when I'm talking to IT admins and CTOs, you know, one of the concepts they're trying to do is they're trying to put, you know, like when you go into a doctor's office, for example, they want to take your temperature, make sure that you're not running a temperature before they talk to you and let you further in the office. Wouldn't it be great if we had Internet of Things and did thermal imagery or some way to automate that before they come in? And, you know,
yeah.
so many big organizations, several on this call, will have hot desking in their environment where they'll have shift workers, three different shifts, you know, sharing the same space in 8-hour increments. Well, aren't those becoming areas that, you know, maybe long term are going to be, you know, places where, you know, infections can occur and so forth between users? And so and then all these organizations out there as well, they furlough, they've laid people off and so forth. And so what's driving this is some new things around automation, right? And how to automate some of these tasks, because we don't necessarily have the team that we used to. We want to automate things that were manual processes like accounting. Maybe we can stand up a SaaS solution in the cloud, make it simpler. We want to maintain those operational efficiencies, but we got fewer people. So, you know, how do we do that? We need to make informed decisions. We need to be making bold decisions on our data and our experience, or, you know, instead of being paralyzed, trying to figure out, you know, what's going to happen. And as far as this new normal, I think what we're really talking about, Randy, is going from static to mobile. I think going from a centralized to a decentralized network, and at the same time, all of this, trying to make sure we do it securely.